In today's video, we're going to be talking about how you can measure your insulin and track improvements to insulin resistance at home. And let me tell you, this video is going to answer a bunch of questions that I am frequently asked. How to test for insulin resistance, how to test for insulin resistance at home, and how to know if your insulin resistance is improving. So if you have any or all of these questions, they will be answered by the end of this video. So first things first, insulin is a hormone that is responsible for taking excess glucose out of our bloodstream and bringing it to our cells for energy. But over time, our cells can become resistant to the signals from insulin. And in response to this, the body creates more insulin to deal with the excess glucose that is still floating around. And it is these high levels of insulin that cause the symptoms that are associated with insulin resistance, including difficulty losing weight, excess abdominal fat, and skin tags. And being insulin resistant puts you at an increased risk of type 2 diabetes, heart disease, and PCOS. By knowing you are insulin resistant, you can start taking steps to reverse it, improving symptoms, and reducing your disease risk. And okay, you might be thinking to yourself, well, if I was insulin resistant, wouldn't my doctor have told me that? Here's the thing. Most routine blood tests do not include testing insulin levels, so insulin resistance often goes missed until it has progressed into pre-diabetes. But what if I told you there was a way to measure your potential insulin resistance at home and track your progress in improving it? Keep watching to find out how. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. What we are going to be focusing on today is the Weight Biology Kit from So Well Health. This is the first ever at-home kit that allows you to test your fasting insulin. So we're going to start off talking about how this at-home test works and if it's right for you, and then we will get into how to measure and track if your insulin resistance is reversing. Measuring insulin resistance. Now, if you guys are already subscribed to my channel, if you've already watched some of my other videos on insulin resistance, you should have a pretty good understanding of what it is and why it matters. One of the main side effects people with insulin resistance experience is difficulty losing weight. This is because when insulin is high in our body, our ability to burn body fat turns off. And this makes sense, because insulin being high is a signal that there's excess glucose in our bloodstream, aka excess energy ready to be used. So if we have energy available, there's no need to tap into our stored body fat, and our bodies actually store fat instead of burning it. So if we already have energy available, there's no need for our bodies to tap into our stored fat for energy. And they actually end up storing fat instead. Insulin is known as the fat storage hormone for this reason. But as I mentioned earlier in this video, when we become insulin resistant, our bodies actually end up producing more insulin. So insulin levels end up being high all the time, hence why it's difficult to lose weight. But other side effects include increased hunger and cravings for sugar especially, fatigue, and brain fog. I have a whole other video that goes over the long list of symptoms that are associated with insulin resistance, which I will link above if you want to check it out afterwards. So if you've been struggling to lose weight or struggling with any of the associated side effects, I recommend using So Well Health's Weight Biology Kit to test for insulin resistance. This kit tests 8 key biomarkers, including fasting insulin, to expose metabolic conditions affecting your weight. So how does the testing work? Let me tell you, it could not be easier. Once you receive your kit, it is as simple as performing a quick, painless finger prick for the sample and then mailing your kit back. And you will receive your lab results through So Well Health's portal in 2 to 5 days. Your results will be reviewed by a physician, and you will receive a report with personalized next steps you can take. Yes. You guys, this is my cat Smudge, who I've had since I was in middle school, or I guess my parents have had now. Oh, she's so sweet. Anyways, sorry, let's get back to it. So if you are someone who has had difficulty losing weight, if you are curious about your current metabolic health, or if you have already made some lifestyle changes and want to track the impact that these changes are having, SoWell Health's Weight Biology Kit is definitely for you. And I've been so excited to tell you guys about this kit, if you can't tell, because having a way to test and measure your insulin resistance at home is huge. This simple test can help so many people get a clearer picture of their health and then know what they need to do to improve it. Because let's face it, the general eat less, move more advice isn't cutting it. But anyways, now let's talk about how you can track if your insulin resistance is improving. Oh, you are so cute right now. Tracking insulin resistance. SoWell Health recommends getting your lab work done at least twice a year, if not quarterly. And there will be many signs in your lab work that can measure if your insulin resistance is improving. So the 8 biomarkers the Weight Biology Kit tests are, of course, fasting insulin, but also fasting glucose, HbA1c, thyroid-stimulating hormone, vitamin B12, HDL cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, and triglycerides. And looking at these metrics can tell you a lot about whether you are insulin sensitive or insulin resistant. By looking at your fasting insulin and fasting glucose, SoWell Health will calculate your HOMA-IR score. A score that is less than 1 means you're insulin sensitive, and this is what you should be striving for. A score above 1.9 indicates early insulin resistance, and a score above 2.9 indicates significant insulin resistance. So as your insulin sensitivity improves, this score will go down. Looking at your triglycerides and your HDL cholesterol can also tell you a lot as well. A high triglyceride to HDL ratio is a key indicator of metabolic syndrome. So as your insulin sensitivity improves, you will see your triglycerides decrease and your HDL increase. And of course, SoWell Health's portal is going to help you to understand your results further. If you guys would like to order the Weight Biology Kit and test your insulin resistance, you can head to healthcoachkate.com/getsowell and use code KATE10 to save 10% off your order. I will put the link in the description box down below as well. But anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. I hope this video helped to answer some of your questions. I know I get asked about testing for insulin resistance a lot, and specifically if there's a way to test at home. Before this test, there was nothing out there. There is no other company who is testing fasting insulin at home. So this is a really, really big deal. And I am so excited to finally have an answer for you guys who are having difficulty getting a fasting insulin test from your doctor. If you have any other questions about insulin resistance, please leave them down below. I will try to answer as many as I can, especially if you ask them right after I post this video. And remember to check out SoWell Health. Again, the link will be down below. If you guys did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on signs of insulin resistance, which I mentioned earlier. You can check that out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find that here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find those here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.